let's come to the first fundamental question. What is a story?
Characters.
Fable.
Characters, fables, emotions.
Curiosity.
Curiosity. Absolutely.
Once upon a time.
The trigger of yes. Getting people ready. Now, if I give you two words, a car and a dead man. Now, your mind has built a narrative around it. So you are probably thinking of an accident. The car hit the man and the man died. It is very difficult for our mind to hold these two images in abstract form in our mind. You will fill in the blanks and that creates a narrative. So we are wired to perceive and to consume the world in the form of a story. There is no other way. So a story is the most intuitive way to organize information in order. Our brain is like a story building engine. It's making stories all the time, even right at this moment. Everything I'm telling you is getting formed in the blocks of stories in your mind. Which brings me to our first exercise, the hidden storyteller.
So I'm going to show you a series of paintings. First one is coming on the screen right now.
So I think the guy who's standing or sitting near the lady must have asked something to the waiter there.
Maybe they are colleagues working in the same company and, you know, something has happened in the office. So they decide to go out for a meal.
Social distancing.
Maybe some me time. She just wants
Me
time. Yeah, me time.
I mean, the feel of winter is there. There's a heater there.
Yeah.
Right.
Very warm clothes. There's a sense of coziness. This is a traveler on his journey. When he goes to sleep in his thoughts, in his dreams, I think this animal comes and...
Okay.
Seems like a musician.
He almost like a wandering minstrel musician. So out of fatigue and... relaxing, gone off to sleep.
So does anybody notice the jar of wine?
I think this lady would have started after lunch having a fight at home, and she kept on walking, and then, you know, she picked the instrument out and then she played it and then she said, oh gosh, you know, where am I?
You know, all that information, do you think that is coming from the picture? What exactly we do as humans, and that brings me to the second building block of this concept, that the world is a projection of our stories. To highlight this point, why do we quickly and in a split second get so much information from these symbols? The world is made of stories, not atoms. What I am about to unveil in front of you is truth based on scientific experiment, and that will display that why storytelling is the most powerful tool of them all that exists in any kind of training, management, and sales and marketing. Let me bring all of you back and your attention to this object that I am trying to sell. This is a ball made of a simple cotton cloth. How much will you pay for it, Manish?
I don't know. 50-100 bucks.
This cotton ball was bought on eBay for $1.50 and was then put back on eBay, and it sold for $51. Why did that happen and how that happened? Okay, let me reveal that secret to you. In the year 2006 in New York, two journalists from New York Times decided to do a scientific experiment trying to find out if storytelling is the most powerful tool. What they did is they went on eBay and they bought about 200 items with an average cost of $1.25. He then emailed to about 200 of his author friends and gave one object to each of them and asked them to write a story where the object appears in the story. It's a fictional story that they had to write. And, they all said yes. They sent their stories back to them. And then he put these products on eBay in something like this form, okay? Where he wrote the fictional story. He very clearly mentioned that the story is fictional, where the object appear in that story. They spent $197 on these items, average. And can you guess how much they earned after selling all the products?
Maybe everything put together.
Yeah, under $5,000.
They sold everything for $8,000. That's a markup of 63%. And that brings us to our third building block of today. That narratives add value not only to things, but to people. You know, I have worked in many companies, and most of you have gone through that journey of working in different companies. I have always noticed and observed that the companies where the employees know the story of the founders of the company, the stories of the owners of the company, or stories of the leaders of the company, the people feel much more connected to that company. The people feel much more emotionally driven to work in that culture. There are companies where people don't know the stories of their bosses or their leaders or the owners or the founders of the company. And which does not mean that the stories don't exist. The stories will flow. The stories will find a way to flow into the culture. If the leader does not control or tell his story will be told by somebody else. Maybe an employee will tell a story. Maybe a colleague will tell a story that this boss is like this, that boss is like this. Or maybe some other great storyteller, whether it's a junior guy or a middle management guy or senior guy, will build your story, which you don't control. So the most important lesson is that always, when you are in leadership position, make sure that you control your story. Because if you don't control it, somebody else will. There's not going to be a vacuum. So if you control your story, it is going to add value to you, to your leadership, and to your team, because they have a story to rally behind.
Now that you're really talking about it, I when I reflect back, I realize that there are so many stories I have shared about myself with my team, and which makes my team feel so connected to me.
Yes.
And I think what you're saying is just actually very powerful, because I am just an expressive person, so I share about my stories, but I realize that, you know, why they feel so connected with me is because I have been sharing so much about me.
Yeah.
And like what you're saying, let there be no vacuum about, you know, who you are as a person, so that people are not left with
any
imagination. Yes. And any gap. You are the one who can really stand up for yourself and talk about yourself and share what you have to share about yourself.
Now, if I talk about Indian scenario, is there any leader story that comes to your mind from the business world?
Ratan Tata for me has always been definitely inspiration, but you know how he has built an empire and what all they do, you know.
Dhirubhai Ambani's story of
yes,
when he came back to India, how he started absolutely from scratch and then went on to what he
did. Even the Gandhi story, you know, like he built the whole Swadeshi movement and everything.
Why do we need to tell our story, and what is the purpose of it? The purpose of telling the story is to highlight your value. Okay, the value that makes who you are, because those are the stories, once you have constructed, will be your gold mine that you will carry in every stage of your life, in every company, from one company to another company, and then you will have a larger epic story because you have touched so many people, and there will be a singular consistent story, and that's the story that we know about Shah Rukh Khan, who has well constructed his story of coming from a small time outside Bollywood to becoming this king of Bollywood, right? And he tells this story. He doesn't shy away from it, right? He makes sure people know that story, and he consistently tells the story. You might have 10,000 stories to tell, right? You need to have one solid story, then you say again and again, and you will realize that you will get better at it, right? You will know where to put the emotional cue, you will know where to put the right words and all that, and you will write that novel. And there's nothing more entertaining and inspiring than writing your own story. Pick that story that will be your story that you will like people to tell.
I think narratives add value to things and people if those narratives conform to the beliefs and values of the people.
It's called point of view. From whose point of view the story is being told. Okay. Now, if you hear Ravan's story, there are great cultures and regions around Southeast Asia where Ravan's story is told as a hero. There are no stories without character. Any characters that stayed with you after you watched a movie or after you read a book?
I read a book called, When Breath Becomes Air. So even today, when I think of the book, when I think of the story, the main character just comes to my mind. And that character never goes out of my mind. You know, you need courage to write when you know you're going to die.
I read this book called Freedom at Midnight, Dominic Lepere, Larry Collins, about the partition of India. I think every page had a character. I mean, the way the country was cut through, the way the furniture was distributed, you know, what a peon would have said to another, you know, so that's so descriptive that you tend to generally just get lost.
You know, always remember the first part that I mentioned, that we project our stories onto the world. The characters that we like are also projections of what lies within ourselves as well. That's why we relate to that. This is a list of 12 archetypes, and what is written in the color box are their key motivation, the thing that they are looking for in life. I'm going to read a few of them for you so you'll get an idea. Somebody who is a magician is the one who makes things done. Okay. Ideally, these would be project managers in your company. And then you have the ruler. Ruler is the one who is seeking control. They are worried about discipline. They are worried about structure, building communities, right? And their fear is a challenge. If somebody challenging their authority is what scares them. So that's the ruler, right? An outlaw, which is on the right in the yellow, is a rebel who is seeking liberation from rules. If I put a ruler as an archetype and an outlaw as an archetype in the same team, it might create conflict. To diffuse that conflict, you would need to bring probably a magician into the scheme of things. Maybe you also have to bring in a sage, maybe an outside consultant, to bring wisdom into that team of conflict that has happened, right? To give you a deeper example of it, everybody has seen Harry Potter. The lead protagonist of the movie is based, his role, his character is written based on this archetype. So these are some of the archetypes that I would like you to study. And a great technique of finding your archetype is also to look at the colorful boxes, you know, the things that you seek in life.
Right.
I just wish that somebody could give me a cup of tea, and it would be great to clone myself and probably get a cup of tea. But, you know, the break is very, very short.
There it is.
Thank you. Yeah, thanks. Okay. Well, and this is the part where I will be revealing you the key elements of writing a great story, not just about yourself, but about the product, about the concept, about the company. So what I want to do is I want you to quickly take a pen and paper. I hope you have drawn the chart. I'll put the chart back again. And I want you to write a short story from your memory.
That's a very interesting thing, Sandeep, you just mentioned. Since my archetype, which I mentioned for myself, was sage, which is knowledge, which is seeking, I don't think the climax hasn't come yet.
It's an innovative product that I created when I was studying at IIT Delhi. So my climax came when I raised investment.
Okay, all right, wonderful. Thank you so much.